Purdue University's Ray W. Herrick Laboratories celebrates its 50th anniversary this summer with 2 days of lab tours and alumni events. When founded in the 1950s, the labs were one of the university's first examples of interdisciplinary research, when animal science professors and mechanical engineering professors teamed to study the effect of climate on animals. Through the decades, the lab has established itself with industry-oriented research ranging from advanced automotive technologies to smart buildings. Current research includes developing more efficient and environmentally friendly air conditioning, reducing building energy needs during peak usage hours, and improving interior air quality.
Anything that survives 50 years in a university setting must have something special about it, right? And I think it's worthwhile to celebrate that specialness about the Herrick Lab.
Herrick has targeted research vital to the needs of various industries. 120 companies from the U.S., Canada, Japan, Germany, Brazil, Korea, and Denmark have all sponsored research.
If you look at what we do, we are looking at applications. We do fundamental research, but we're also both the faculty and the students involved with the sponsors and looking at how that new research can be used for better products.
Herrick's July 19th birthday banquet was timed to correspond with the lab's two annual conferences, the International Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Conference and the International Compressor Engineering Conference, draw hundreds of researchers and industry executives from 30 countries.
It's very important that you have an international reputation, you know, in whatever disciplines that you are hoping to be successful in. And Purdue Herrick Labs does and has, and that's come about through individuals, I think, and their involvement in societies and publishing, presenting papers abroad, but also working with companies, international companies.
Herrick's energy efficiency research extends to the internal combustion engine. Herrick is developing more efficient and cleaner automotive power plants.
The engine, people would like to do more work on advanced engines, on hybrids. To do that, the machinery that we need to do that kind of work is requires a lot of power. We don't have that. So what this will do in that particular area will mean we'll be able to expand the type of research that we can do, and so we can work on much more ambitious and more far-reaching research.
The summer celebration serves as a prelude to a groundbreaking this fall for an expansion that will double the square footage of a facility that began as a horse barn 100 years ago. Herrick has already raised $9 million of the $11 million needed for the 16,000 square foot first phase expansion. At Purdue University, I'm Jim Shank.